your God, Jesus.
My God, who you also believe to be your God.
Well, I don't think it's my God. I'm a Muslim, by the way, just to make it clear.
My Muslim friends have told me that we believe in the same God.
Yeah, God means the God of Jesus. Not Jesus as God. There's a difference. Because Jesus himself claimed that he believes in a God. Are you aware of that?
So we agree that we have different gods.
So can God have a God?
Can God have a God?
Yes.
No, but God is God.
No, no, but
you're missing the point.
No, no. Can God have a God? Like, for example, if Jesus...
God by definition cannot have a God because he is God.
Absolutely. So, did Jesus have a God?
Jesus is God.
No, but did he have a God?
No, he is God.
So when he says, I go to my God and your God, what do you understand?
He says, my Father.
He also says, my God after that.
A different form of himself.
No. He says, I go to my Father.
I fail to understand what...
Calm down, calm down. I'll tell you why you're failing to understand, because you did not know the
word. I don't fail to understand. No question about understanding.
Well, here, calm down. No need to be so arrogant. You haven't even heard the argument. You haven't even heard the argument.
I've heard the argument.
So in John 20:17, hold on. In John 20:17, when Jesus says, I go to my Father and your Father, my God and your God. When Jesus says, my God, what do you understand?
His Father.
No, we already know. He claims that that Father is also his God. If you believe Jesus is God, and as you claimed earlier that God cannot have a God, then how do you reconcile the fact that Jesus has a God?
He doesn't.
Well, he says, I go to my God.
I'd like to see which translation you're reading here. Because as far as I read...
John 20:17, which one do you read?
I read the King James Version.
Okay, open King James and let's see. No, he says, my Father and my God.
Understanding.
Let's open King James Version, which you read, and read that verse I was telling you. John chapter 20, verse 17.
Says to my God, I will admit fault.
Good. So you know from Jesus' own statement that he has a God. Now do you agree that he has a God? Or you're going to say the Bible is wrong?
That was good. On that one, I would have to do some research, bro. I don't want to give you an incorrect answer.
Why do you have to do research when the Bible clearly says that Jesus says, I go to my God?
I claim to know everything.
You don't have to.
Like you, I have come here to learn.
Based on face value of that verse, what do you say?
Based on face value?
Yeah.
One would assume that Jesus is a God.
Good. Now the question I would ask you is that if Jesus himself prayed to God Almighty, yes, and he put his face on the floor like the Muslims do when they go to the masjid and do sujood, yes? I'm not saying the entire prayer of Jesus was like that. I'm saying at least a sujood. The prostration that he did was exactly the same. He fell on his face and he prayed to God, what? Take this cup away from me. Let it be thy will be done, not my will. Yes? Do we agree that that prayer of Jesus was rejected?
Yes.
Can you imagine your God's prayer got rejected? What chances do you have that? If you pray to God, what chances of your prayer has been accepted when your own God's prayer got rejected?
But you need to understand that this is God in human form.
But he's also fully God. You keep saying that. He's fully God according to you. If he was only human form, I have no issues that he prays to God. Why should I have an issue? Because we all who believe in God pray to that God.
If you saw Jesus praying to his God in the Garden of Gethsemane, would you then pray to Jesus or would you pray with Jesus to God?
Good question.
You'd pray with him. So why do you worship him?